Hey everyone, today we're diving into an awesome recovery tool from Dr. Andrew Huberman, the carbon dioxide tolerance test. This simple zero-cost test can tell you if your body's ready to train or needs a rest day. Let's see what Huberman has to say, and then I'll guide you through trying it yourself.
I'm really keen on this tool because everybody has different recovery abilities. I realize people have varying levels of stress and demand in their life. It's just impossible to prescribe an entire protocol that says, okay, yes, you should train today, and this is exactly what you should do. No, you shouldn't. Use carbon dioxide discard rate because A, it's valuable, it's informative. B, it's zero cost, and C, it's something that you can track objectively over time. And that's really the key. So recovery is a complex process. It's got a lot of things, but the CO2 tolerance test should be a valuable tool. So here's how you do the carbon dioxide tolerance test. You wake up in the morning, and what you're going to do is you're going to inhale through your nose as deeply as you can. You can do this lying down, sitting, whatever. Inhale through your nose, and then exhale all the way. So that's one. You're going to repeat that four times. Then you take a fifth inhale as deep as you can through your nose. Fill your lungs as much as you can. And if you can try and expand your, make your stomach go out while you do that, that means that your diaphragm is really engaged. So you're inhaling as much as you possibly can. Then hit the timer, and your goal is to release that air as slowly as possible through your mouth. So it looks like you have a tiny, tiny little straw in your mouth and you're letting it go. As slowly as you possibly can. Measure what we call the carbon dioxide blow off time or discard rate. I know you can all sit with lungs empty after you eliminate all that air, but don't lie to yourself. Don't stop the timer when you've been sitting with your lungs empty for a while. Stop the timer when you are finally no longer able to exhale any more air. Your carbon dioxide discard rate will be somewhere between 1 second and presumably 2 minutes. 2 minutes would be a heroic carbon dioxide discard time. 30 seconds would be more typical. 20 seconds would be fast. If your carbon dioxide discard time is 20 or 25 seconds or less, you are not necessarily recovered from your previous day's activities. If your carbon dioxide discard time is somewhere between about 30 seconds and 60 seconds, you are in what we would call kind of the green zone, where you are in a position to do more physical work. And if your carbon dioxide discard time is somewhere between 65 and 120 seconds, well, then you have almost certainly recovered your nervous system. I'm not talking about the individual muscles, but your nervous system is prepared to do more work.
All right, now I'll guide you through the Huberman carbon dioxide test. So you're doing four deep inhales and exhales, then a fifth big inhale, and you exhale as slowly as possible while timing it. Are you ready? Let's do it. Take a deep breath in. And fully out. Take a deep breath in and out. Fully in and fully out. Four. In and out. Last one, the big inhale. Fully in.
And now, exhale slowly as possible. That's the carbon dioxide tolerance test, a legit game changer for tracking recovery. As Dr. Huberman says, it shows how your nervous system's doing right now. Quick recap, 1 to 25 seconds, take a rest day. 25 to 60 seconds, you're ready to train. Over 60 seconds, you're good to push harder. So, how'd you do? Drop your time in the comments, tell us how it went and how you're feeling, and let's keep optimizing. Big thanks to Dr. Andrew Huberman for this amazing tip. Check out the full episode of his podcast linked below. Smash that like button, subscribe for more, and let us know if you're loving this kind of content.
Click the join button to become a part of our membership program. Unlock exclusive content and enjoy more benefits on your journey. We wish you all the best and have a good one.